What's up, y'all? Sion here again today with another video. Hey, y'all, but today I wanted to talk to y'all about hobbies. Alright, yeah, we all got hobbies. Hey, and this is the thing about these hobbies. Sometimes they can get expensive. But I'm going to show you how you can enjoy your hobbies on a budget. Check this out. Okay, as you can tell, my hobbies are cars and motorcycles. I love them dearly. Team Chevrolet. I love my Harleys, but I currently own a Honda. But y'all, I want to tell you, one of the main ways you can enjoy your hobbies, you want to set limits. It's just something to do for fun. You don't want your hobbies to turn into things that cause you problems because you want them to bring you joy. My hobbies, like I said, I like cars. I have an old car. I have a 1978 Nova. I love my Nova, and I love my motorcycle. I have a 2005 Honda VTX 1300. I love my motorcycle. And you might say, well, Sion, you talk about being frugal, but you have a car and bike. Yes, yes I do. And that's the thing that I tell you all about. Save your money up and then buy the things you want. And I don't waste a lot of money in those things either. So for instance, like my 1978 Nova is a project car. I work on it from time to time. Hey, it's okay, it keeps me happy. But the way I have to do it is I have to moderate how I do it. Not all my money is tied up into that car. Because, for one, I don't want to tie up a lot of money into a depreciating asset. And that's the same as for my motorcycle. So what I do is I just set limits on how much I'm willing to spend. So it's either one or the other. So I put my Nova on the back burner so I can put full attention on my motorcycle. So because it can't get expensive. I know buying tires and fuel and oil changes and basic maintenance, all that stuff can get expensive. So what I do so it won't kill my pockets is I just limit. If I'm going to mess with the motorcycle, I mess with the motorcycle for a while. If I'm going to mess with my car, I mess with the car for a little while. I just balance it out because I know I can't do both. Because if I do both, it's going to take a lot away from me. And I'm not interested in spending a whole lot of money in those things at the same time, because I can only enjoy one at a time. But for a lot of people out there, you're in the same boat. We all have hobbies, we all have things we like to spend money on, and that's perfectly fine. But we just gotta understand, all right, these are hobbies, and we're not trying to allow them to cause us any extra headache than necessary. We wanna enjoy our hobbies. So that's one of my things I do. Another thing I do, I buy discounted parts. I check eBay. eBay has everything. I mean, eBay is such a great site. So whenever I'm looking for an extra accessory for my motorcycle or for my car, I'll go to ebay.com, type it in, bam. Or I'll check Craigslist. One of those sites is somewhere where I don't have to spend a whole lot of money in buying specific parts for either vehicle. Another one is I learn how to work on my vehicles myself. That will save you a lot of money. Just practicing, going out there, solving your own problems and not having to pay a mechanic to help you solve minor problems. YouTube is my best friend when it comes to fixing my bike or my car or just adding on modifications to either one. So whenever I want to add mods, I just go to YouTube, I type in what I'm trying to do to either vehicle and it'll help me save time and money. Because one of the things I've noticed is a lot of those mods that you can do and that you can pay someone to do, you can simply do it yourself and you don't have to come off that extra fee or that labor fee that they're gonna charge you at a dealership or a specialized mechanic. Like I said, a lot of this stuff is really basic stuff. It's just, hey, someone has to get paid for it. They went to school to learn a trade, so they're trying to get paid. But so you don't have to go through that. You can just go on YouTube and YouTube will tell you everything you need to know. And that's one of the great things about it. Another way I save money with my hobby is I allow other people to just sponsor me pretty much. So as what I mean to sponsor is not any big sponsors, but I allow family and friends to help me. Like, there's no shame in my game. I have two holidays throughout the year where I take advantage of. That's my birthday and Christmas. My birthday falls in August and Christmas falls in December. So I'll take advantage of those days and I'll try to get as much as I can during those times so I don't have to spend the money on it. For instance, this shirt was a gift, the This hat was a gift. This clock was a gift. All my Harley Davidsons were a gift. The picture was a gift. This was a magazine. I just cut the front off of it. But I didn't have to pay for it because they sent it in the mail for free. And this is just a great poster. You can use your family and friends to help you purchase parts and accessories when need be. Like I said, a lot of them are on your mind. They know that's your hobby. They know that it makes you happy. I have a good friend, like when my birthday came, one of my buddies bought me a pair of sunglasses from a motorcycle. And they were very nice sunglasses, and I'm thankful they bought them for me. But I really appreciate it. I said there's all sorts of ways you can enjoy your hobbies and you don't have to break the bank. Like, there's plenty of opportunities out there. There are plenty of websites that'll save you money. You can even buy wholesale. You can go into buying certain items wholesale so it can cut you deals. Like, for instance, when I'm on my motorcycle, I like to buy masks for the weather. You can get those from little to nothing if you buy them in bulk. There are so many ways you can save money in your hobbies. And like I said, I try to take advantage of everything because I love my hobbies, but I don't let them burden me financially. All right, y'all, I just wanted to share that with you. Like I said, this is something that meant a lot to me. And I just wanted to share this with you all to let you know what my hobbies were and kind of explain why I got the weird background up and that I'm talking about being frugal. All right, y'all, I'm gonna talk to y'all later.